All right. Hi, everyone. Indigenous people groups are essentially overspoke to among the world's poor. In Asia and America, for example, development indicators for Indigenous people are continually worse than the populace midpoints. Indigenous women and men face discrimination, abuse, and different infringement of their common liberties. Indigenous women, on the other hand, are defenseless against discrimination from both inside and outside of their networks. Underestimation and financial prohibitions of Indigenous people are not uncommon. Despite of the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous People, or most commonly known as DRIP, and the 2014 World Conference on Indigenous People, where states reaffirmed their pledge to respect, promote, and advance these rights. Now, about 60 million Indigenous people from around the world depend entirely on forests for their survival. Indigenous communities carry on to be removed from their own territories under the plea of large-scale infrastructure projects. Forest displacement of Indigenous people from their own traditional forests play a major part in the distress of these communities. Non-recognition of Indigenous people and also their rights in many countries have worsened land, income, and food securities. Likewise, the poor systems to guarantee the consent of these Indigenous people in decision-making have resulted in distress and bigger socio-economic prohibitions. Now, ladies and gentlemen, according to the United Nations, the human rights of Indigenous people includes 3 points. The first one being the rights to their land, territories, and their own resources, including to those that are traditionally owned by them, but now held by others as a matter of law. For many Indigenous people, their connection to their land, territories, resources is not only a matter of possession and production, but also a spiritual aspect which they must fully enjoy, even if it's only to preserve their cultural legacy and pass it on to their future generations. Now, moving on to the second point, which is economic, social, and cultural rights, which is Indigenous people's rights to health, education, housing, and an appropriate standard of living. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the third, but definitely not the least, is equality and non-discrimination. Indigenous people are also human beings. Let's not forget about that. They deserve the rights to be treated the same as other people and free from any kind of discrimination that are based on their indigenous beliefs, indigenous origins, or even their indigenous identities. Now, I'm sure that all of you are aware that Indonesia is filled with rainforests. But did you know that Indonesia, with 10% of the world's rainforests, is losing approximately 900 hectares of forests for every year? Over the last decade, despite the increasing of recognition that deforestation is a real and a serious issue, attempted solutions have been done is proven largely ineffective, which leads to hundreds of Indigenous people losing their land. They have lost their access to everything, to food, water, and basically anything that they need for survival. Furthermore, the Indonesian government, by denying land use rights to Indigenous people, have worsened the problem. Many Indigenous people have no legal title to their lands and often lose their lands to companies. And so, because of that, it's common for these companies to just burn large areas along to make new roads to plant tobacco or coffee without any concern for long-term sustainability. In West Kalimantan, for example, the Indigenous people there have stated that the rivers they rely on drinking, fishing, household chores, basically anything that they do on a daily basis, have become polluted. Not only that, but before these companies made the plantations, they could make so many things to sell, such as rotan, wicker, and basically everything. They sold all of it. But after the plantation, it has become much more difficult because it is way harder to find the materials. What's worse is that they don't even have a place to live in. They are literally living in plastic tents that are repeatedly being forced to move away. We miss our trees. We missed our forests. We missed our home, they said. So, how can we help? A World Wild Resources Institute study has found that deforestation in indigenous community forests from 2001 up to 2012 were less than 1%, compared with the 7% outside of them. So it shows how securing forest rights are more successful at slowing forest clearing and decreasing emissions. To add that, over 30 years ago, the Declaration on Rights to Development broke new ground in the international struggle for greater human dignity, equality, freedom, and justice. It called everyone to be empowered to join fully and freely in important decisions. It demanded equal opportunities and better governance at the international economic framework. And it redefined development more complex than previous decades. So we should keep in mind that people are not the how of development. We are not the tools that can be exploited to produce greater wealth, especially indigenous people. Instead, we are the why. True development corrects the causes of poverty and other massive issues. True development that brings greater social justice. Thank you for your attention. I am Jasmine Nora Sabrina from Al-Azhar 14 Senior High School.